Welcome to St. John of Nepomucene's celebration of Easter Sunday of the Resurrection of the Lord. Peggy Fabian, I'll be your cantor today. I'm joined by Brian Schnurman of the Joyful Sound Group, Debbie Tomko and Barbara Pace, and Don Johnson on the organ. Father Joe, our pastor, will be presiding, and he's assisted by Deacon Roger Mott and acolyte Terry. We also have with us our lector, Sister Lisa Bergeron. To begin our celebration in song, please sing with us, Jesus Christ is risen today.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. who on this day of resurrection, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. And we make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and of the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness, that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
precautions. Brothers and sisters, if you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Could not hold Jesus back, and death in all of its forms is destroyed by resurrection. Today is the foundation of everything we believe, and it today represents all of our hope for the future. And although we cannot gather as a parish family as we always look forward to doing, along with all of the friends of our parish, let's remember that this day can really change our hearts, our lives, and our world, because a great gift is given to us today by God. What happened almost 2,000 years ago on that first Easter morning can happen to all of us now. We can rise with Christ. We have been called to rise with him. Because Jesus conquered death, we can rise out of the deadly experiences of our lives to something better. I can rise out of selfishness into love. I can rise out of greed into generosity, out of despair and worry into hope. I can rise out of conflict and anger into reconciliation and peace. We can all rise out of fear and anxiety into trusting God and finding the same peace that Jesus wished upon Mary Magdalene when she first saw him risen from the dead. He said, "Peace be with you." See, the resurrection of Jesus is so important, and for Christians, the most important day of the year, because it represents a whole new way of dealing with life. All of our failures, all of our bad choices, all the hurt and the pain, all the bad news that can touch us in this world has been overcome on that first Easter morning. And if we accept that Jesus is risen, we are invited to step out of the Good Fridays of our own lives and find that joy and peace that is what this day is all about. We can walk with Jesus out of the tombs of our lives. It's important for us to understand that when Jesus rose from the dead, he did not come back to his old way of life, but he moved forward to a new life, a new kind of existence. And that is the gift of Easter for all of us. It's the opportunity to move forward out of darkness into the bright and blazing light of resurrection. A question: can any of us remember a time in our lives when our whole world needed this truth of Easter more than it needs it right now? The pandemic is global. It's a massive Good Friday. It fills us with anxiety about our future. We ask questions like, when will we get back to normal or how it used to be? As so many people have said, people of strength and of faith, we'll get through this together. We'll get beyond this with love. And that's what's waiting for us on the other side of the pandemic. A better world, a new life. Despite all of the suffering, blessings have already appeared that can represent to us resurrection. The blessing of medical workers, people in service jobs, workers in the food and pharmaceutical industry, first responders, police, firefighters, and so many others, too many to mention. All those people who risk their own safety and their own health to care for the sick and the needy and to serve us, they are the heroes and the saints walking among us. They are the signs of resurrection, messengers of what Easter Sunday represents. But you know, as much as they are blessings, there are other blessings in these dark days. Maybe they are blessings yet to be discovered as we continue to endure the Good Friday that will lead us to another Easter morning. such as perhaps this pandemic will bring us a greater awareness of the fact that what each person does affects the well-being of our neighbor. The simplest gestures of washing our hands and keeping our distance in an effort to overcome the virus. How about another blessing? It may be that we discover a deeper understanding of how we're all part of one human family. No matter what nationality, religious persuasion, creed, or color we are, we're all part of one human family. We all can get afraid of what's happening, but we can all be united in the love that will heal us, and in that sense, be messengers of resurrection to others. Another blessing could be that we could develop a clearer vision of the power of love and love's ability to offer healing on every level. All of these things can be blessings that come from the Good Friday of the pandemic. All of these are experiences of resurrection. They are signs of what happened when Jesus walked out of the tomb. And they call us forward as truly as he did not go back to his own life, but went forward into an utterly new kind of life. Christ can become more alive in human hearts. I want to say thank you on this Easter to all of our parishioners who, by your faith, have made St. John's not just a place of prayer, love, and compassion, but you've made our parish a place where the risen Christ is evident, where he lives. He lives in all the ways that we reach out to the sick and the needy. He lives in the parents and the catechists of our parish who pass our faith on to our children. The risen Christ lives in all those who generously serve in our liturgical ministries to help us to pray as a community. And the risen Christ lives in a thousand other ways, especially in every act of kindness, patience, and love that his Spirit prompts us to perform for others. He lives in our parish outreach program, which has been so active as the pandemic gets worse. Many of our outreach volunteers, being of a senior age, have had to withdraw for safety reasons, and the younger volunteers have stepped forward in their place and have packed food and delivered food to the hungry, another sign of resurrection. Thank you to so many parishioners who have walked into this empty church and filled it with groceries that we can use to feed the needy. Our world needs Easter and its healing love. Religiously, culturally, politically, and environmentally, there is much turmoil in our world. In the middle of all this comes Jesus, risen from the dead, and telling us we can overcome any darkness that might touch our hearts or disrupt our world. Peace and harmony and healing is possible if we're willing to probe deeply into how the Lord's resurrection can change us, and how this gift of God can empower us to be effective instruments of his resurrection for others. My dear parishioners, my dear friends of St. John's Parish, my dear fellow Christians who celebrate the hope of the resurrection, we look forward to that day when we can return with you here to the Lord's table, to the Eucharist, where we receive the risen Christ. In the meantime, we say Happy Easter, and thank you, God, for empowering us to be the messengers of the good news that we celebrate every time we come to the Eucharist. I conclude these thoughts of Easter with the words of Pope Francis that were used in this past week. First, our Holy Father posed this question when he talked about the cross and Good Friday and then the resurrection of Jesus. The question he offered was, why did all of this take place? And he answered, it was done for our sake, so that when we have our back to the wall, when we find ourselves at a dead end, with no light and no way of escape, when it seems that God himself is not responding, the Holy Father said, we should remember that we are never alone. Jesus experienced total abandonment in a situation he had never before experienced in order to be one with us in everything. He did it for you, for me, for you, and to say to us, do not be afraid. You are never alone. The Lord said, I experienced all your desolation in order to be ever close to you. The Holy Father goes on to say, this is the extent to which Jesus served us. He descended into our suffering to raise us up into the joy, the glory, and the peace of his kingdom. With those words, the Holy Father and all of us here at St. John say, Happy Easter. Lord, help us to be that people of hope. Help us to be coming back to your table soon so that we can be fed on the body and blood of the one who rose from the dead, so that we could rise with him and offer all of the gifts of peace and joy that his resurrection represents to a hungry world out there that wants to rise with him. One of our traditions performed in every Catholic church throughout the world on Easter Sunday is what we call the renewal of our baptismal promises. The original meaning of the 40 days of Lent was that it was a time of preparation for adults who were preparing to be baptized at Easter. And in that spirit of baptismal commitment, we renew our baptismal promises, for most of us made when we were infants, by our parents and godparents. We renew our baptismal promises by responding to these questions with the words, I do, as a commitment that we want to rise with Jesus and make his resurrection the healing instrument that our whole world needs. And so wherever you are watching this Mass, I invite you to respond with the words, I do, to these questions. My dear brothers and sisters, through the dying and rising of Jesus, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in the newness of life. And now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you all, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by selfishness?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
The Christian word for yes is the word amen. I ask you to say that word amen to this profession of our faith. These questions that we have responded to represent our faith. It is the faith of the Church, We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Our custom, as you remember, on Easter Sunday is that I'm privileged to walk through the crowds of Easter and sprinkle them with this baptismal water. Today, as I bless myself with this same Easter water, I do it in your name. I do it with your intentions in my heart, for my heart is praying for all of you that Easter will be a new beginning for all of us. And I do it with the promise that when you all return here, we will be sprinkled with baptismal water as Jesus welcomes us back to his table to receive him in the blessed gift of the Eucharist. Christ is risen. Hallelujah. Let us be one in mind and heart as we pray to the Lord on this glorious day and offer up to God not only our own needs, but the needs of the whole human family.
Our response is, Risen Lord, hear us. For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, our bishops, and all church leaders, that they may help us in bringing about God's kingdom of peace and justice by our participating in the Lord's resurrection, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear us.
That the peace of Christ may bring healing and hope to all those in our world touched by the turmoil or conflict, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear us.
For all those who are victims of the coronavirus, those who are sick, those that are anxious and afraid, those who are grieved at the loss of a loved one, that the healing love of Christ may give them comfort and hope in the future, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear us.
That the joy of the Lord's resurrection may continue to bring hope and enthusiasm to our entire parish and to the ministries by which we reach out to the needs of all our people, and that St. John's may be a source of strength to all who come to our community, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear us.
For all those who have recently died, especially loved ones, we now remember in the silence of our hearts. And especially for those who have lost their lives from the pandemic afflicting our whole world, that God may give them the fullness of life and joy in his kingdom, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear us.
For all those petitions sent in as prayer requests, and for those intentions known only in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear us. Heavenly Father, you give us Jesus to be our salvation, our hope, and you send the Holy Spirit to be our guide. Hear our prayers and fill us with the strength to seek your will in all things. We ask this in Jesus' name and through the power of the Holy Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Receive our reward in glory, for he had loved the ones who
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the glory of his holy church.
Filled with Easter joy, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ, O Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but especially in this Easter season, to praise you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Easter joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you now have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on these offerings of your church in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And granted by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity so that together, with Francis our Pope and John our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and with your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may all strive to bring joy and trust into our world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all who have gone to their rest, whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place in heaven and live with you forever, there in your kingdom, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the apostles and martyrs, with our beloved patron, Saint John Nepomucene, and with all the saints, we will praise and exalt you forever through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, the peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Take away the sins of all.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. I am the bread of life. I am the hope in night. I am the door wide open, I am the shepherd's light, I am the truth and light, I am the way and life, I am who am and I am for you, come and follow me. Thank you.
your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by these paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. Before we conclude our liturgy, I want to thank everyone who is viewing and praying with us. And I move to say that on Easter, that the strength of any parish is its people. I often use the phrase, beloved parishioners. That includes everyone. Parishioners who come here to pray with us every Sunday, parishioners who live within the boundaries of St. John's. You're all beloved parishioners to us, and we are always eager to welcome you. And as I speak about beloved parishioners, I just want to mention that there's someone who took part in our videotape liturgies through Holy Week, who you don't see on the screen. His name is Ray Foster. He's one of our beloved parishioners whose skill and abilities with the camera we are so grateful for, in being able to video these ceremonies and share them with you. And I want to say to all of you parishioners who may be listening that we hope to continue to do this, at least on Sundays, for the foreseeable future, until we can gather together here in our church around the altar. I want to just say a special thank you to parishioners who have been with us to help us to pray in this unique way on videotape. I thank Carolyn Drago, who was elected for the Palm Sunday Mass, Anthony Giovanni. Both of them are not only our lectors, but are so eager and generous to serve in that capacity. And I thank Sister Lisa for being our lector at this Mass today. A special thank you to our deacons, Deacon Jim Boslaw, who was with us through Holy Week, Deacon George Reach, who was the deacon at the Good Friday service, and Deacon Roger Mott, who was the deacon here at this Mass today and proclaimed the Easter Gospel for us so beautifully. And I thank Terry Culhane for assisting at this Mass. He's a future deacon. His ordination date, we're looking forward to with great eagerness, hopefully in May, maybe later because of what's going on. But our deacons are such a powerful sign of service that we can all imitate, service to God's people. A special thank you to our music ministry, Peggy, our leader of song, Don, our organist, and today, Debbie and Barbara and Brian, who are with us, they just helped us to pray with that incredibly beautiful song, How Beautiful is the Body of Christ. All of the gifts that are shared by our parishioners that help us to minister to God's people are beautiful gifts of the Body of Christ. All of you out there are part of the beautiful Body of Christ. And because we have that power of Christ within us, not only the power of our baptism, but through baptism, the power of the risen Christ, we can restore beauty and hope and health and peace to our hurting world. Happy Easter. Friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God always bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thanks be God.
Let us go in peace to glorify the Lord by our lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.